around. Some of you responded to email and sent me names ahead, and I have those. So if you got an okay back when you sent those, that means they're on this list. If you did not get an okay back from me, then please make sure it's on that list. And please print. I have to read what you wrote. And so that's making its way around. Can someone wave it who has it right now so we just kind of know where it is at? It's not stuck anywhere. Okay. All right. Okay. Sorry. It's good to see you here today. That is nice. Okay. All right. Schedule-wise, we launched our Hope Strong program last week. I'm glad you all are in prayer. We had a group of five come, and they left going, we will be bringing more. And sure enough, we are expecting more again tomorrow. So that is an exciting thing. I'm really grateful for those who help out. Today, afterwards, we have a quick setup for tomorrow. If you are able to lend a hand, that would be great, because we get here early in the morning and we just want to have everything ready to go. So, all right. So this week is our final week before our congregational meeting, and there's details about leadership positions we are trying to fill. The person you may talk to or ask questions, I'm glad is here, and it is Mike Miller, who's our congregational president. Do you have any more things you want to say, Mike? Just in addition to that.
Information will be going out Thursday, all the reports and yes. The budget and all that, we will be voting on. There are a couple issues we'll also be tackling. One of them is the quorum, but we'll get all the information in your hands. It'll be fun. Go eat afterwards. We'll take care of the business as we do this time every year. Outside of that, an orderly line up front for those that want to run for council positions open.
Yeah, orderly lineup.
Suzanne is going to run for treasurer. We're going to try to find somebody to work with.
We are
that
looking.
Position over. We do need a trustee, a deacon, and an elder. And outside of that, the one other thing real quick, there's an election coming up, Pickaway County Board of Elections. Print out your ballot, know the issues, so I don't have to wait long.
Yes. That is an important thing, that is, we are called to be of this world, and yet we know there's great amounts of tensions that go, and we all end up sometimes on different places. One of the things about being people of God is we choose to respect and love one another, even if we don't agree with them. And so that is a blessing we have. I can't imagine being those who go off to vote without community to know, accepts and loves them as they are and is willing to work with them. So I pray a lot about that. It's important to me that we all be those who show ultimate respect to one another in these processes. So that's my pastoral message, I guess. All right. Council meets on Wednesday, because we are bringing you stuff on Thursday. Oh, here's what I'm missing. Next Sunday, it does fall on second Sunday for those of us who learn together and come for Sunday school. So that is a great gathering. We gather across the generations that day, and it has surprising little pieces about that. So please think about coming as you are, as family. We are looking at the parable of the wise and foolish builders, and it's called Bible Bites this year, and she literally does give us something to eat as we learn, and we get breakfast besides. So come. We usually can accommodate and have people busy from little ones up through 80s. So come and be a part of that. All right. I think that is it for me, until we look into birthdays and prayers and those kind of things. So any other announcements? Yes, Julie.
Yesterday, for Bob Bob's memorial dinner, I kind of overestimated. I had no idea how many were coming. The family didn't give me any idea. So there's a lot of food left. Thank you so much for everybody that contributed. You're always there for me when I call on you. But there was a lot left, so go over and check the refrigerator. Your dishes are over there. I think I'm going to have Ray be my numbers man from now on. He estimated exactly pretty much the number for people that would be there. So when you don't have any idea, you just want to have more than not enough. So.
Yeah. So especially if, if you brought, thank you, go check the fridge and plan your meal around what you worked on already. All right. Okay. Anything else? I saw a line over here. Yes. Or a hand.
Mutual Ministry Committee, if we can please meet up front after church for very, very quickly.
We're trying to set something. Yeah. Okay. All righty. Those are announcements then. I am now going to turn to yes.
Yeah, Rick. I just wanted to throw in there. I counted the boxes of potatoes that we have from what Betty's turned in and what's in the back right now. We're just about at close to 197 boxes. We're halfway to our 200. Got a couple weeks left, so keep those boxes coming and thank you for your support of the food pantry.
So you said 197. Does that mean 100?
We have 97.
Okay. It was a rounding thing. Okay. All right. So yes. So watch for those. I know some of you have super creative ideas of how to get a bunch, ship them in. So So look for those. We're mashed potatoes for Thanksgiving, and I believe next Sunday is when you need to get them here. I think we're that close. Am I right?
It's been a couple of weeks.
If you got to do it now. So it's coming closer.
We have to let them know if we don't think they're going to meet our goal.
Because they buy ahead.
We let them know that they'll go buy what they're not able to get. So they'll get their numbers, but it's much better if we can provide them to save their numbers for something else later.
All right. I am looking closely. And we're celebrating birthdays. And Tim Hoska and, oh my, Paisley 3 Acre, Jacob Reed, Cliff Hoover. Oh my gosh. And we have a bunch of you. And what a. Paisley, I'm glad you're here to represent your generation. You boys can come up if you want to stay with Dad and Uncle Jacob. Yeah. All right. God has given us the gift of this group. Let's sing them happy birthday. Coming up, we are thankful to God that you were made in secret in your mother's womb, and here you are as a gift to us. So, all right. Okay, let's start gathering prayers. Yes, Gary back there.
Elaine's not here today, and she's not one to be put on the prayer list, but if we could have a thankful prayer. Friday evening, she was in the basement when Max called and hit her head on the metal post in the basement. So she gets to spend about 5 hours at Malcolm Emergency. She now has 6 staples in the back of her head. And we were, she lost quite a bit of blood, but thankfully she did not have a concussion, and thankfully she did not pass out because I was outside. But thank you because they put that in the office. But she didn't want to come big, but she hadn't had, they didn't want to get a shower yet.
Oh, that's a big thing. So a thanks that Elaine got through that and that you were able to get to her. I mean, just all the little pieces along the way. Yeah, she'll show us her staples, won't she? Yes. Go ahead, Rick.
Mother went to Dr. Lyon on Wednesday, and she's now on once every 4 weeks. And for the first time since February, when we first took her to keep up her ailment from us, her diabetic wounds, every one that she has, they all have tissue covering them. So her Achilles tendon is covered for the first time in 9 months. And so keep praying for her, and she's been a lot better, pray with mine, seeing some positive.
Seeing progress.
Yeah.
So continued prayers for Wilda. I think, you know, we give you the list because some people's journeys are very long term when it comes to health issues. And then they see little glimmers of hope, which that's a good one. That's a good one. Yeah. All right. Any others? Particularly, I see new baby Haven is here, and we could, you know, she should just let us listen to that baby. She went out because maybe it was, well, I don't know. We're happy that baby Haven is here, and that's been a Thanksgiving. To the Christie's doing okay, and all right. Yes, Donna.
Post-strong update, we're now up to 13 students. There are some openings in November, so if you're interested in helping with snacks, with only 13 maybe you don't need to be far, we're going to be 35. So if you're interested in helping, let me know. Thank you.
What if we keep growing, you'll update that?
I'll keep everybody notified before Monday morning.
Great. Thank you. All right. Yeah, I'm looking around for you. I have one thing that came to mind this morning and I almost forgot about it. It was 20 years today I had a craniotomy. And if you look at my stuff, I didn't have a partial craniotomy. I had a full craniotomy. And that was a big deal. And at the time, I had this wide group of the saints of God praying for me. It is 20 years later and I'm still here. We did a whole battery of stuff to check on me again, and I am stable, and this was a big deal in my life, and prayer is what has got me through and sustained me. So I give thanks for prayer, and it came from places that I didn't even know or understand. So our prayers are powerful. They're powerful in the way that they support other people to get through and to heal. I really believe that some healing is that miraculous healing, and we don't know why. We don't know why some people don't do well, and that's part of what we have to talk about sometimes. Why isn't that prayer answered when others' prayers are so fully and completely? But I'm giving thanks for that. I'm giving thanks that I'm a 20-year survivor of hacking into my brain. So that's what it felt like at the time. So, all right. I don't have anything else there for prayers. I think we're ready to lead into worship. You may be wondering, because I asked you all to bring pictures, and I don't know how many of you were able to even do that, but we're going to have a time. I'll explain to you then what we're doing, and other people have taken the idea and have some expansion for it today, too. So I'll let you know when we get there. We're going to head into worship time now. We're going to listen to a prelude from Ellery, and then we will sing together. we stand together and sing the hymn, "In Christ, There Is No East or West." And that's number 359 in your green hymnal, where we've printed it out in those digital sources. Grace, mercy, and peace be with you all.
And also with you.
All right. I'm going to let you get a chance to be seated because we just need to do this way. I invited you to bring, and I don't know if you had a chance, to bring pictures of those that you remember as saints in your past. And I did that with mine to give you some placeholders. And then to write down there the gifts that you know you carry from them by being with them. And in the middle of this out here is a picture of Jesus embracing the world. And that is our status together as saints. Now, Gary was inspired and Ray to share about some of the saints that they knew about. And so, Gary, this is your time. Were you expecting it to be now? He asked for it, so I'm not surprising him.
This is not one of my usual talks. I thought it would only take a minute or so. But Ray and I talked about this yesterday, and Ray said something about getting some of the pictures out of the display case. And that's because the Neunker family, well, River Roof, our founder, had four daughters. Two of them ended up marrying Neunkers. If I remember right, one of them was Nathan. And I think the reason two of the girls married Neunkers is because the Neunkers were a prolific bunch and they were the only men around at the time.
The Roof girls were the only females around.
But
look at the pictures, you'll understand.
Yeah, I have to look at the pictures. But one of the girls married a Baum, which is another prolific family. And the fourth one then married a Snyder. And a Snyder married a Peters, which is my family. So that's how the Baums and the Neunkers and the Peters became a large part of the original church. But another family was the Huffines. I was hoping John would be here because the Huffines didn't marry into the church. They were in the area to begin with, and they were a number of Huffines were members of the original congregation. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And they're all saints, the Baums and the Neunkers included.
Yeah. Yes, because we do believe that saints are not about perfection, they're about what God has done in them. So, but that's good for us to remember. And yeah, sometimes I'm just amazed at who I talk to, and yeah, we are kind of halfway, you know, related to that group. So it's something that draws us together in interesting ways. So I don't know how you guys are. Some of you have brought those pictures and you're ready. Do we have anybody who has any, or you guys know that was too hard, we didn't know what you meant, they are all at home? Yeah. Oh, we got somebody getting up. Yeah. We're going to bring up some things. And I have push pins up here. And we'll just put them in. And if you didn't bring one because you weren't sure what we were doing or if it was too scary, we can keep building on this through this month. So that's an okay thing. Yeah. Because collage means they're all going to come together, aren't they? Thank you, Emily. Yeah. It's not too big. It's not too big. We have some of these here. How many do you think? There's also the possibility to draw. Right here, we have paper and pens. This is so small, I expected it to be huge. No, no, it's on the Amazon. Yeah. I will say, as a pastor, whenever you participate in some of these things, it allows you to work on goodbyes and memories and thinking about where you're at now. It helps you process any grief that's still there in you or your life to actually do the project and thinking through what they gave you. So I'm really grateful to those of you that went ahead and you got enough.
Yeah.
And I love the color of that. Yeah. Okay. All right. We're going to name names. You know, we always bring those names that you have brought during prayer time. And that's where that is going to be. But for now, we're going to have a little bit of time where we pray, keeping these in mind. And I know those, I know for a fact you have those in your families. And you are welcome to keep on bringing pictures. Remember that all of us and all those you remember, this is our place in the world, in the arms of Jesus. And that's our place. And that is an assurance that we are a saint even when we have broken lives and even when we need to put back together. So we're gonna stand together and I'm gonna do a prayer. And then we're going to do a short litany. So please stand. We praise and bless you, O Holy Trinity. You have taught your church that it is an ageless communion of saints. We thank you for gathering those who faithfully waited in hope for the redemption you promised. And now for adding us who celebrate the love of Christ for the redemption of the world. Prepare a place for us among those who are already with you. Help us remember them as an encouragement to saintly living, exciting us to love in anticipation of an eternal reunion. With them we praise and bless you, O Holy Trinity. Amen. Amen. Jesus says, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light, and you will find rest for your souls." Okay, now we're going to sing the hymn of victory. This is the feast. This is the feast that we celebrate, the feast that we share Christ. cross the boundaries of time and space. So let's sing.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia.
Almighty God, you have knit your people together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated, and we're going to listen to our readings.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Our first reading today comes from Isaiah 25, verses 6 through 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation."
Our psalm for today is taken from the 24th Psalm, and we will read it responsively. If you are following along in your green hymnal, you'll want to be on page 225, and then we turn toward 226. The earth is the Lord's, and all that is in it, the world and all who dwell therein. For it is he who founded it upon the seas and made it firm upon the rivers of the deep. Who can ascend the hill of the Lord, and who can stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not pledged themselves to falsehood, nor sworn by what is fraud. They shall receive a blessing from the Lord and a just reward from the God of their salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them high, O everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them high, O everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is he, this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Now we'll listen to Revelation 21.
Revelation 21, 1 through 6. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of the heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, see, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. And he will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed. And the one who was seated on the throne said, see, I am making all things new. Also he said, write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Please stand for the proclamation of the gospel. Jesus has received word that Lazarus has died, and Jesus has finally made his way there. And so we begin with Mary's encounter with Jesus. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And when Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. And he said, where have you laid him? And they said to him, Lord, come and see. And Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, see how he loved him. But some of them said, could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying? And then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. And Jesus said, take away the stone. Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, Lord, already there is a stench because he has been dead 4 days. And Jesus said to her, did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. And Jesus looked upward and said, Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me. And when he had said this, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come out! And the dead man came out,
his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. And Jesus said to him, to them, unbind him and let him go. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. We're going to have kids come forward. And we're going to, oh, you're already here. Oh, it's because Paul's your leader down there. He gets everything done on time. Okay. I had the most awful revelation last night. I went down to where you guys hang out during church. There are no blocks down there. I thought for sure we'd have blocks, but we didn't. So we're going to build a tower with cups. Okay. Have you ever done tower building with cups? Okay. All right. So count with me. All right. All right. Okay. So this is 1, 2, 3. We're going to build a steeple. All right, count with me. 4, 5, 6. We're going to build a steeple. Okay, what comes next? 7, 8, 9, 10. Oops! There it went down. You've had that happen. You're going to build it. Okay. Right, yeah, go ahead and keep building it. 2, 3. We're going to build a steeple. 4, 5, 6. We're going to build a steeple. 7, 8, 9. I thought we had 10. We're going to build a steeple. Now this one is standing up, and I heard Sadie say, it's because they're closer together. What have we done? Did we skip numbers?
No, there's 10.
You're right, Beck, there's 10. Whoa, and there it came down. Now, we're using our little tower today to teach us some things about what it's like to be part of church together. Wow. Sometimes the steeple gets, the church falls apart, and guess what we have to do to make it get back together again? What do? We get closer. How do we get closer as people together here? It's a magic thing we have. It's called forgiveness. Forgiveness. And we, as saints, we are ones that are saints because we're forgiven. And so we forgive each other. And when there's the big oops, we come together again and say, let's forgive each other because God forgives us. It's all right. It's for building. Okay. All right. I know. Okay. Let's pray together. All right. Let's pray together. Dear Jesus, thank you for forgiving us. Thank you for forgiving us. Help us forgive one another. Help us forgive one another. Amen. Did you know it's because of forgiveness we get to call each other saints? Isn't that amazing? And there's even Saint Beck and even Saint Reed. So, Mom, I'm reminding you of that. They are called beyond this moment. All right. Okay, we're going to head back down. You guys are going to head back down with Miss Amy and Paul. All right. And then I will see you later because we have communion together. We'll get to share a blessing. Yes. You guys can take these. There's nothing really high-tech about them. Yeah, Mika, are they letting you share? She's in it. She's like, I'm sharing. Whether you like it or not. All right. Let's pray together. Dearest Lord Jesus, I thank you for all that this All Saints Day brings to us. I'm especially thankful for it after weeks where death was in our midst. I'm thinking about lives lived. It was in our midst. And I thank you for the gift of this day. The gift when we are reminded that there is a greater flow than the flow of our lives. And it is the flow of your mercy and your love. And it is what holds us and embraces us, no matter what. I thank you for that. Be with me as I share my short message. Be with those who listen. It's in Jesus' name, amen. So, I did know we were putting a lot of stuff into today. And so I have a few words that I think are important for us. And they are about, few words about saints. Now, saints are not about perfection. They're not about elevation or recognition. We've had that misunderstanding at times. Saints are not goody-goodies. Saints are flawed and failing humans who have their eyes set on Christ. And through that vision before them, they become adept at forgiving and at healing and loving and giving away being right for the sake of connection. They learn to accept the cross as a way of freedom, trusting that God takes whatever we have, even if it is nothingness, and recreates and renews even when there is not enough. We live in that space. Now, Ellery and I discussed the hymn that I had chosen yesterday, and he's like, this is not a good song to sing. And I said, I have no idea how that got in there. And we went and found it. And it was suggested for one of the other assignments of readings for the day. But I think it is a great definition to read those words about sainthood. And then we're going to say one we know. So, just so you know. But here were those words. When the poor ones who have nothing still are giving, when the thirsty pass the cup, water to share, when the wounded offer others strength and healing, we see God here by our side, walking our way. And that is a saint's life. And then the second verse. When compassion gives the suffering consolation, when expecting brings birth to hope that was lost, when we choose love, not the hatred all around us, and God is with us. We see God here by our side, walking our way. And that's the way of a saint. When our spirits, like a chalice, brim with gladness, and when our voices, full and clear, sing out the truth, when our longings, free from envy, seek the humble, we see God here by our side, walking our way. When the goodness poured from heaven fills our dwellings, when the nations work to change war into peace, when the stranger is accepted as our neighbor, we see God here by our side, walking our way. And that's the way of the saint. And it's important to have that in our hearts as we celebrate together this day. So, Ella and I, late yesterday, said we better sing something more familiar. So we picked out 174 in the green hymnal, and you have to go there because we don't have this in your digital bulletin. And I think we have enough to share. So 174, For All the Saints, verses 1 and 2, and then 6 and 8. That's what we decided, right? Okay. All right. You may be seated to sing. For the prayers now, and I need to locate this. Yes. I have a little clergy family joke. That hymn, we sang every verse from my dad's funeral because we were always tired of, for the sake of congregation, cutting back verses. And so for his funeral, we sang them all. And because he loved them all. So, all right. Now, I have this list. What I want us to do is, it gets lengthy when I start reading names. Just let's breathe. And, you know, those saints gave us their time, and we will give them time. So, let's go ahead and pray together. Rooted in God's abundant love for the world, let us pray for our neighbors, the church, and all of creation. O God of resurrection, you call us by name and raise us to life. Rouse your church from slumber, where we have held back in fear or shame. Unbind us. Embolden us in our proclamation of your good news, that all may know abundant life. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God of creation, you have founded your world on rivers and seas. Preserve fresh water sources and the creatures who call them home. Heal places of pollution and nourish places of drought. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God of the earth, you reign over all nations and peoples. Inspire us with wisdom and discernment as we elect legislators and leaders, particularly our president. May they govern with justice and uphold the dignity of all people. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
O God of heaven, you make your home among mortals. Come alongside those who weep this day. Befriend all who are lonely. Encourage those in despair. And heal any who are suffering. I want to pray today for our sister Sally, who prepares for a procedure. I want to pray also for Elaine, as she continues to heal from her injuries. I pray for Wilda that you continue to preserve her. I want to pray for families, especially who we know are still carrying grief, the Baum family, and also the Welches and the DeVold family. There are many others in our community who are carrying heavy burdens because of the loss of loved ones. Be with them also. Abide with your faithful ones in love. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God who serves, you set before us a feast of rich food. Sustain our ministries of fellowship and hospitality, especially Second Sunday, the breakfast and the lunch gatherings. Bless our Hope Strong gatherings where breakfast is shared, and also our men's prayer group. We thank you that you give us all the living bread from heaven. Strengthen the hands and hearts of all who prepare and serve food in this place for our nourishment together. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God, Alpha and Omega, we give thanks for your faithful ones who are now at peace with you. We remember Wayne and Mary Brown, James Butler, Wayne and Lillian Brown, Wayne Bud Brown, Marcia Balthasar, Neil and Martha Jean Brown, Paul Teagarden, Alvin and May Barr, Rick Brown, Phyllis Lee, Penix Teagarden, Robert L. Baum, Dorothy Baum, Kurt Bickle, Brian Cavendish, Bernard Cavendish, Harold Tosca, Mick Tosca, Gloria Stiles, Lehman Stiles, Hayden Lee Carruthers Seymour, Ron Yonkin, Mildred Yonkin, Jim Seymour, Francis Hunter, Marjorie Jones, John Woodruff, Hannah Schooley, Alpha Ramey, Jerry and Mala Lee Trigo, Howard and Marge, Jeff Reed, Margie Pickering, Jim Pickering, Ruth and Kenny Dean, Dana and Alice Welch, Todd DeVold, Alton and Lois Loveless, Albert Newsom, Alva Deer, Durr, Medford and Jean Good, John and Shirley Barnes, Ed and Ruth Pritchard, Suzanne Gervis, Karen Lee, Mary Pritchard, Ralph and Zora McCain, Dick and Betty Wenderoff, John and Doris and Don Bell, Richard Bumgarner, Carl Bumgarner, Dorothy Carl, Charlotte and Roy Stover, Harold and Nellie Bumgarner, Arch and Clara Lou Stewart, Martha and Maynard Hulse, Ray Horn, Dan and David Jordan, David and Tootie Belender, Helen and Wright Noaker, Dorothy Bruning, Connie Rittinger, Jean Van Pelt, Chester and Thelma Noaker, Don and Rosalie Berry, Joyce Van Pelt, Margaret Trimmer, Melvin Bitzler, Jerry Cummins, Pete 30-Acre, Rich and Lucy Carpenter, Bill Rindler, with all your saints, we praise you, for you have swallowed up death forever. Merciful God, receive our prayer. We offer our prayers to you, gracious God, trusting in your boundless love for all that you have made through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you.
Also with you.
I'm going to encourage you to stand up and share Christ's peace with one another.
Thank you.
I want us to try a new offertory for November. This is a month where we give thanks, and we start out giving thanks for saints. One of the things in our process of giving thanks, we see that all of our lives have been given to us. An offering is a time where we give of ourselves. I like this because it says we are an offering. So you want to turn to 232 in this hymnal. And if today you're like, I don't know if I want to sing along with this because I don't know if I know it. Maybe you do, but we'll sing this. We'll be learning this as an offertory. So go ahead and stand because we usually stand for our offertory. Some of you will know this. Some of you I know know this. Continue with the great thanksgiving. Oh, I have an offering prayer. All right, let's pray then. Lord Jesus, our portion and our cup, you offered yourself in love for the world. And in this meal, you nourish us with your life. Fill us with your abundance, that we may feed the hungry and welcome the stranger, trusting in your name. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the witness of your saints, you show us the hope of our calling and strengthen us to run the race set before us, that we may delight in your mercy and rejoice with them in glory. And so, with all the saints and the choirs of angels and all the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. And said, "This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And then after supper, Jesus took the cup, He gave thanks. He gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. It's shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. The meal of our Lord is ready. It is the Feast of All Saints. The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Thank you. God in Christ to do for you. Please rise. May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace until life eternal. Go in peace. And then a blessing as you go on your way. Remember that the ancient one enthroned and the crucified one now risen and the indwelling one poured out among us blesses you now and forever. Amen. Okay, we're going to sing together verses 1 and 4 of Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. That's 315 in this hymnal.
Thank you. to live and share the gospel of Jesus Christ through love and service to all.